learning. In this example, I'm going to show how to build both a horizontal scroll bar with a floating buttons and a vertical scroll bar. Okay, so it would seem like this would be a simple problem, but actually it is kind of challenging. So here's our floating button here. Let me just minimize so you can see that working. Okay. And you'll notice that you're not getting any overflow errors. That's kind of the beauty of it. And then I can drag and drop this way, and then I can scroll vertically. Okay, then I also have my input box here. And the principle here is how to deal with infinite spanning containers. So for example, a list view is greedy, meaning it has a infinite bound. And so we're gonna start with the parent container and move down to the child. So let's talk about what we have. We have column, we have an expanded row, and in the row we have my text form field, and just set a boundary. So I've got my form field, a decorator, input decorator, and then I put a label text, call it input, and then I'm going to underline the input boundary, set a boundary size. I'll set the boundary size color to red, and I'll set a radius of it all of 5 and 10. Okay, so what that means is that gives it kind of that look and feel. There's my input, here's my boundary that I've established. It's underlined so you can see where the text form field is. Okay, so segment 1 is the horizontal scroll bar and segment 2 is the vertical scroll bar. So let's go look at them. Okay. So the horizontal scroll bar's got the most code. And what I've done here is I've given the expanded a flex of 1. Okay, so then that's a flex of 1 and the vertical is a flex of 3. So now that if you take those two expands in the column, that would be 4. So the first one would be 1 and of 4, and the second one would be 3 of 4. So that's how it's going to dissect up the page. Okay, so that's the real trick there on the segments, and it's real critical that you set the expanded so that you don't have overflow issues. Okay, so in the segment 1, I've got a single child scroll view, and inside there I'll have a container, and I'll use that container will be the height of 150 and the width will be the size of the screen. I'm going to set up a row, and then in that row I'll have a floating action button, and it will then call scroll right, and it's connected to a controller. So let's just go up here and look at our scroll right. So we have a horizontal scroll controller, and it's a scroll controller type. And then I'm going to animate that, and I'm going to move that to the max scroll extent, and the duration will be 1 second. So that'll do the scroll right. Now the going backwards, instead of having the max extent, I go to 0. So it goes in the reverse now. When I press the floating button to the right, it will now cause the scroll to move back to the origin of 0. Okay, so that's our floating button controller. So now what we want to do is actually build the list view. So I've got my list view builder. List data is has a record, and in it it has a header, and also let's go look at that so you can see that. Oh, in this case, I'm sorry, it only just has a string of characters A through Z. So just put it just a list of strings, that's all it is. It's not, but if you want, you can set that up as a class, and then you can index the class as a list of class items. All right, so we'll set the scroll direction to horizontal, and the we'll set the horizontal scroll controller on. We'll set our container edge inset, so it's going to be your margin, and we'll have the height as 100 by 100 card. Then we'll just grab the list data by index and set the alignment equal to center. And that creates our horizontal scroll bar. Now there's one little catch that you're going to have to use when you're dealing with the web, Chrome web, and that is you're going to have to set up a material scroll behavior. So you can extend that off of material scroll behavior, and we'll set the drag device to touch and mouse. And then when we set up our material application, we set the scroll behavior to my custom scroll behavior. If you don't do that, then your horizontal scroll, when you're doing the drag and drop with the mouse, it won't work. So you need that particular function, that scroll behavior, my custom scroll behavior, and then set that drag device is equal to touch and mouse, and then that turns that feature on. I don't know if that's a bug or if that was intentionally left out, but I had to find that on Stack Overflow to get my horizontal scroll to work. All right, we're jumping down to segment two. So segment two is quite a bit simpler. Again, we have expanded flex equals three list builder, and we'll use the vertical scroll controller. We'll set our list data. We just use the same data set. We could create our own another data set if we want. Context and index, set our container as 150 and 100. So width is 150, 100, set our margin as 20, and then set a list tile and pass the value as text. So there you go. There's how you set up a horizontal list view and a vertical list view, and also have a, so there's three segments, an input text form field, a horizontal scroll list view, and a vertical list view, all working together on one page.